what is the structure of a city? I'm going to show you four pictures. Here they are. New York, Paris, London, Amsterdam. You can see they're different. If I characterize it quickly, you might say this is the 19th century grid of New York. The boulevards, the big boulevards of Paris. The patchwork of railroads, old villages and parks and in-between building of London. And the circular canals of Amsterdam. So you can see the differences. But actually, what defines this structure? How is it made? Urbanists think of that by using five layers. I'm going to show you. Here they are. Where's my small pencil? So the basic of it is the landscape. The slope, the wind, the water, sun, north, south. This defines the start. And this is what you will recognize best, the building upon it. The buildings have a mixed use, usual. It might be commercial, housing, bars, restaurants, public buildings, schools, and in between is a public space. Oh, here it is, public space of streets, trees, squares, parks, and quays. This together defines the urban plan, and this is quite crucial for our business and, say, the adapting possibilities of a city, because the urban plan defines the balance between the public and the private. The private is privately owned, hard to change, or changes in a different time scale as the urban plan and the urban structure. So you might say the in-between of the private is the public and defines the urban structure. This is how you can read the differences. Well, if you want to read more about this and study it, there are lots of books. We will add a short list of the best, well, some of the best, at the end of the course. But actually, what urbanists do, their book is, oop, here it is, The City Map. This is how we read a city. If you learn how to read a map, you can handle every city. And actually, all you need, tracing paper, a few pens, and there you go. That's it.